Sex is what we do, sexuality is what we are. Let's look at sexuality on a broad spectrum, not as an act of intimacy, but as a self-identifying factor. Your sexuality includes the following. 1. Your physical appearance and your gender attractiveness, such as body shapes and femininity for women and muscles and masculinity for men. Number 2. How comfortable you feel in your body. Do you accept your body? Are you often criticized your body? 3. How attractive you feel with your partner. How attractive you feel in your romantic relationship, when you flirt or when you go out with your partner. Number 4. How easy it is for you to receive pleasure in life. Not just sexual pleasure, but pleasure in general. The ability to experience pleasure, joy, and happiness. Number 5. Do you feel comfortable when you give pleasure to another person? And number 6. How much do you like your self-reflection in the mirror? As you already learned from my previous webinars, people with overweight problems often feel unworthy and often experience low self-esteem. It is particularly true when it comes to their physical body. Although some people might present themselves sexy and confident, in reality, this is just another defense mechanism to hide their vulnerable little boy or little girl inside. If we are being honest with ourselves, then we can see that sexuality always reflects our self-perception. Extra weight often helps us to hide our insecurity in romantic relationships. You might disagree with me and say that some people look very sexy and are not afraid to show their body even if they're overweight. This is true for some people, but not for the majority. Even some of those sexy mamas in reality are pretending that everything is fine. They are pretending that everything is okay. They are playing the role of a sexy, confident person, but actually they are protecting a little child inside of them. Their inner child is hurt and scared. Extra weight is a common defense mechanism to hide emotional pain and insecurity. Let's talk about how we use extra weight in our lives. Number 1. Extra weight helps people to hide their sexuality. We are hiding our beautiful body, shapes, and curves behind the extra weight. Number 2. Big people wear big clothes. Hoodies, white pants, and oversized sweaters are adding extra layers to protect their vulnerable body. Number 3. Women with extra weight don't wear heels, and heels, as you know, are sexy. Number 4. Women with extra weight don't show their body on the beach and don't wear sexy swimsuits. They usually don't swim at all. They hide their body from the public. Number 5. Men with extra weight can't show off their muscles, and they can play volleyball on the beach. They usually take their drink and hang out in the pool area. Number 6. Women with extra weight sleep in big pajamas and almost never wear a sexy nightgown. Women who did not receive acknowledgement of their beauty from parents, especially from their fathers, are afraid to be beautiful. They don't know how to react when they see that a man desires them sexually. They are afraid to be sexy. They don't know how to accept compliments and how to be hot and feminine. Men with extra weight often feel that they are not worthy of dating beautiful women. Such men might be sexually attracted to a feminine woman, but often they doubt that a woman like that would fall for them. Most men won't even try because they don't want to be rejected. Let's do a small test. From 1 to 0, where the 10 is the maximum, how much do you love and accept your own body? This includes how much you take care of your body, doing exercises, beauty services, massages. How do you feel when you spend money on yourself, not on your loved ones, but on yourself? Do you accept your own body during intimacy? Are you allowing yourself to make noises and facial expression during sex? Are you okay with body odors? Don't try to overthink this. It is a simple self-diagnostic test. You don't have to do anything with this number. You don't have to share this number. This is just for you to reflect on it. Let's talk about how food and sexuality is connected. Food and sexuality share a common element, pleasure. Food and sexuality are all about physical and psychological pleasure. Pleasure in general is the ability to receive joy, fun, and happiness. It is an ability to relax and let go of control. This is not as simple as it sounds, of course not. We live in a world where we have lots of tension, lots of stress, discomfort, and anxiety. Our daily routine can be overwhelming. We live in fear. The world is developing quickly with rapid advances in technology, modern science, and social media. All those things make it harder and harder for us to predict our future. We live in fear. We fear the unknown. Pleasure is occupying less and less space in our life. By the time we are in bed, we are exhausted. As you've learned from my previous webinars, and if you haven't seen them, please check them out. All the links are below in the video description. So as you've learned from my previous webinars, food helps us to deal with stress, helps us to relax, and of course helps us to receive pleasure. When we eat, we feel good, quick and easy. Often people don't even notice this defense mechanism. Often people use food to compensate the lack of love, sexuality, pleasure in their life, and they do it subconsciously. They don't even realize it.